Hello children, this is revision session. In this, I'll revise chapter 6, changes around us. To recall your previous knowledge so that it will be easy for you to understand and recall your previous knowledge again. So kindly listen to me. In class, we discussed about this chapter. So we studied two major changes that are reversible change and irreversible change. First, you should know what is reversible change. Reversible change means a substance which has undergone for a change. After that, you are able to get the original substance means that is reversible. I'll explain you with a few examples. You are using a paper to make an aeroplane. So here the paper had been folded in the shape of aeroplane. If you unfold it, you can get the paper back. So no new substance is formed there. So that change is reversible change. Instead of folding, you are crushing the paper, or else you are crushing the cloth or blowing the balloon. So these are the some of the examples of reversible change. Okay, in case of crushing the paper, only the shape and size of the paper had been altered. In blowing the balloon, if you inflate it, you can get the original balloon back. In the same way, compressed spring and dough to roti. You made a dough and you rolled as a roti, but you didn't cook it still. So this is also a reversible change. From the roti, you can make a dough roll again. Okay, ball of dough again. So these are reversible changes. First, try to understand what is reversible. Reversible means the original substance can be get back at the process so that it will be easier for you to understand with examples. Next is irreversible change. It is quite opposite to the reversible change. In this change, you will get a new substance. That is, instead of folding the paper, you are burning the paper. So while burning, what you can get? Only the ash and the smoke, but you can't get the paper again after burnt it. So that is a irreversible change. In the same way, bursting of the balloon. While you are blowing, the balloon is overfilled with air and it got burst, so that you can't get the original balloon back. So that is a irreversible change. In the same way, you are having a dough, roll of dough, and you rolled it into a ball of dough you have, and you rolled it into a roti. So that is reversible change. If you cooked the roti into chapati, you can't get the dough back. So that is irreversible change. I hope now you are clear with the reversible and irreversible changes. Cutting of wood is a reversible, and in the same way, burning of wood is a irreversible. Cutting of vegetables, reversible. Cooking of vegetables, irreversible. Okay, children. So be clear about reversible and irreversible changes. Further changes we will discuss in class. Thank you.